stronger in his faith. He grew stronger in his belief for what God had promised him. Abraham, ladies and gentlemen, hoped against hope. When you hope against hope, that means that you have confident expectation that God is going to do something for you that is beyond what you can visibly see. God is going to change your current situation, even when your current situation refuses to change on its own. He had a hope in a God who was able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that he could see. He had a hope in a God that could change his natural situation. He had a hope that God was going to make him the father of many nations, even though he was old. Ladies and gentlemen, Abraham believed in El Elyon. Abraham believed in Elohim. Abraham believed in Jehovah Jireh. Abraham believed in Jehovah Shammah. Abraham believed in the God who was able to bring things back to life. Abraham believed in the God who was able to create something out of nothing. Abraham believed that God would do something for him that the doctor said would never happen. Abraham believed that God could just speak a word to his wife's barren womb, and immediately a plethora of children would begin to flow. I choose to believe in that God. Ask your neighbor, do you believe in that God? I believe in that God. The God who heals. That God. The God who gives peace. That God. The Lord my shepherd. That God. The Lord who sees in the dark and blesses me in the light. That God. The Almighty God. That what God has promised, he was able to perform. But this is the confidence that I have in that God. That if I ask him anything according to his word, that God is going to Come on, come on, come on, TD. Come on, come on. Why am I calling these women forth? Why am I calling these women forth? Because I want you to see what prophecy looks like. I want you to see what prophecy looks like. It starts off with, I am perfect. I am complete. I want and lack for nothing. That means you passed. 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 So then the devil dumps some old junk on you. But that's all right. The confession does not change.
Take care of your babies, saith the Almighty, for I shall feed you
like the raven fed the widow. Trust me, not the system. Trust me, not the man. Trust me, not your family. But trust God in him already. He's shifting his position in your life. He's moving from the middle into the place of authority in your life. Trust him, and you shall never worry about a dime. Not ever in your life. Every time the offering goes forward, you wonder, can I meet it? Can I meet it? You won't have to worry about that anymore. You won't worry about that. Now God crowned her head with wisdom. She needs it, God, for the millions you are going to release into her life. A crown her head with wisdom, Holy One. Give her instruction and direction. Guide her feet. God, connect those to her that you have called to her life, God, to help her to go forth in ministry. In Jesus' name, amen. I know the word of God. Hallelujah. Well, it's delivery. Today is the day of delivery. Amen. Can you pray in the Holy Ghost? Share, I need you singing. Can you pray in the Holy Ghost? Today is the day of delivery. I saw you with your arms lifted up. Yeah. But not only with your arms lifted up, your feet were in the stirrups. And I saw you pushing in the spirit. So Lord God, come forth. Saith the Almighty God, come forth. Saith the Almighty God, come forth. Saith the Almighty God, for there is an evangelist that's inside of you. There's a ministry inside of you that's outside of the walls, saith God. So get into the street and bring salvation to those that are lost. Saith the Almighty God, open up your mouth and speak with us, saith the Lord. I rebuke all error in the name of Jesus, and I decree from your lips nothing but the truth of God's word. Go forth and speak. Go forth and speak. Go forth and speak. Go forth and speak in the name of Jesus. Come on, clap your hands and give it glory.
Listen, I believe in marking moments, and I need you, ladies and gentlemen, to get a seed in your hand, to get a seed in your hand. Listen, givers get. I know you already gave in the offering, but this is over and above what you have already given. I need everybody in this house to get a $27 seed. Why 27? Because 7 is the number of completion. Okay, we are going to mark this moment as the moment you became perfect, complete, you wanted and lacked for nothing. But listen, there are those of you that are here, when you get your 27, I need you to stand up and come this way. There are those of you that say, Pastor Fran, I got 127 that I'm going to sow into the kingdom because it means that much to me. I want to mark this. This is a serious life-changing moment. If you're here today and you're going to stand with me with the 127, wave your hand at me. Woo! Shout. Hallelujah. Listen, if you're going to give the 127, I need you to put it in my left hand. If you're going to give the 27, I need you to put it in my right hand. But we get ready to go forth because guess what? God is doing great things just for you. Come on, Chad, let's do it. Father, bless the seed of the righteous. Come on, upbeat. Thank you, God. Father, bless the seed of the righteous. God, we give you praise. Bless the seed of the righteous. Increase and overflow in the name of Jesus.
Something's moving, something's changing. if you receive what God has to say to you today, there's something that's getting ready to move, something that's getting ready to change in your life. I don't know if you know this or not, but there were a group of women in our church that we were going before the throne of grace on your behalf, believing that God was getting ready to do something miraculous for you today. So if you don't know who the Lord Jesus Christ is and the pardoning of your sins, I'm going to ask you to come right now. Secondly, maybe you do know who the Lord is, but you are searching for a church home. Well, The Rock or New Kingdom is not the only church that is preaching and teaching the full gospel, but we're so grateful to be one. Thirdly, maybe you had an incident, something happened in your life, and you found yourself outside of the will of God. Well, I got good news for you today. God is standing right here with his arms wide open, saying, "Backslider, come on home." Fourth and finally, maybe you are void of that dynamite power with the evidence of speaking in tongues. Well, we've got Holy Ghost full counselors here today that will help you, give you the desire of your heart. So if you don't know who the Lord is, if you have found yourself in a backslidden situation, if you are looking for a church home, or if you need the infilling of the Holy Ghost, won't you come? Church says, amen. Everybody, before we go somewhere, this is such a sweet Holy Spirit that came into this place. So instead of having our usual flowers to this and all that to that, I want to close this out with something memorial. Jada, are you here maybe?
She's right in front of you.
Can you come and do something for us? Can you minister to us real quick? Amen.
Bring it on!
crown, Jesus reigns.